Now, my special guest today, oh, you should see this biog. It'd make your eyes water. It is so full and packed of a wonderful, wonderful experience. He is a fabulous singer. He's been described as a Michael Bublé, as a Frank Sinatra. The superlatives are never ending. It is Gary Williams.
For some reason, as a kid, you know, I used to like this song. And I, if we'd had sort of anybody came round, not even family parties, if anybody came round to the house, I would stand on a little table like this, and I would sing this song. And of course, it was so cute, you know. Yes. Everybody, I was probably, you know, 6 years old or something, and everybody loved it and applauded. And I thought, oh, I like the attention, you know. Because, of course, you know, all performers are complete egomaniacs and just love attention.
Yep.
My friend loved Kylie Minogue. And I remember over at his house, and he was playing this Kylie stuff, and I was listening to her, and I really wanted to try and get it.
You were listening to I Should Be So Lucky.
Right, it was that was
lucky,
the one at the
lucky,
time.
Lucky, lucky.
And then at the same, there's that on, and then I'm listening to the lyrics of Hoagy Carmichael, sort of, and now the purple dusk of twilight time steals across the meadows of my heart. It's like poetry, you know,
and beautiful.
I loved these lyrics.
Mellifluous.
And, oh, there's a
That's a word.
Oh, we should be on Countdown.
Oh, I know. Give me a chance.
You'd win with that.
Because you were probably only about 19, something like that, 18.
So I went to see, a friend took me to see this amateur dramatics thing, this youth theatre show, and I loved it, and I thought, I'd like to be a part of that, because I'd never performed, you know, even though I knew I could sing a bit, you know, because I sung around the house. So I joined, and the lady that ran that, who's a dear friend of mine still now, she was really pleased because, as it happened, I didn't know this at the time, but as it happened, my voice type is a light baritone, which lended itself very nicely to all of these lovely old shows like Rodgers and Hammerstein, you know, like Oklahoma and My Fair Lady, Guys and Dolls. And this was a whole sort of repertoire of shows that she'd wanted to do in the theatre group, but never been able to because she didn't have anybody with that
type of voice
that suited it. Every now and again in your career, you meet what I call angels, somebody that they don't want anything from you, they're not trying to make a book, they really like what you do, and they've perhaps got a bit of money and some time, and they just want to help you. And this guy called Paul Gregory just wanted to help me. He was one of these guys. And he said, what you need is a bit of profile. He said, you need to be working with one of the famous big bands in the country. And so he was ringing around. And of course, nobody wanted to work with me because I'd never worked with a big band before at all. And they're like, who's this guy, you know? So what he does to solve the problem, he calls the BBC big band. So that's probably the most famous, you know, most respected big band in the country. And he said, look, I know you're not going to work with this singer because you don't know who he is, but I'm going to put on a concert at the Hull City Hall. I'm going to pay you a very generous fee. I guarantee it'll be a sellout. It'll be broadcast on local BBC radio. I want you to do it on the one condition that you will work with my singer. If you don't work with him, I'm not going to do the concert with you.
Is he a millionaire or something?
He was just a very nice guy, very generous guy. It was called the Rat Pack Live from Las Vegas, which you probably have seen.
It was
a great fun show. Yeah. So this was a new experience for me, being in a structured show, working with a director, with a choreographer, and you know, learning a script and so on. But I learned so much from doing that show and had the best time.
How long was the run
on and off? I was only in it for about 3 years. I did 150 performances.
Gosh. So a long time.
On and off. I wasn't in there for all that. No. You know, I'd go in. At that time, there were mainly two of us sharing the role, a guy called Stephen Triffitt, who really does look and sound like Sinatra, and me. And we would sort of, he'd be in the West End, and there was a concurrent European tour, so I'd be out in Europe doing that, and then we'd swap over.
Yes.
And I'd come into London, and he'd do a bit of the European tour. I absolutely love cruising. I still get excited about it before I go anywhere. I mean, genuinely, I do. I'm really excited about this Brazilian thing. You know, all the cruises that I've just mentioned to you, I love it.
Well, I tell you what, some of the women get rather excited as well. Let's just take a look. This is what lengths they go to get to him.
Thank you, Mother.
Because I love to travel. I love seeing all of these incredible places. I was just in Istanbul the other week, and I learned lots about the history there, you know, and I'm going back. So for me, it's perfect.
So you're a happy bunny, as they say.
Yes.
Oh, great. Well, listen.
And a lucky one as well.
Oh, well, yeah, you make a lot of your own luck, I tell you. Gary Williams, it's been an absolute delight having
a
chat with you.
It really, we've had a lot of fun, haven't we?
We've had great fun.
Hopefully we'll see you on a ship
next
time.
I hope so. I'm Debbie Jones. Do take care. And I'll see you next time here on Cruising with the Stars.